taken certain steps, that is vulnerability study, and the climate change action plan also we have prepared. State action plan for climate change has been prepared, and we have included our work in that particular action plan. And I'm happy to share that this bio village, college biotech club, and we have one DNA club. I will tell that story afterwards if there is time. That has been taken care, included in our state climate change, apart from the agriculture and allied sectors activity. Vegetable crop might bring disaster for me if there is a 5 days, that means rainfall, from 65th to 70 day. So everything will go. So considering that, the alternative way of earning something has been kept here, and that the components are as per the interest of the farmers, I mean villagers, and the potential of the villages. Our intention is to enhance the village GDP and also to ensure additional income of the family to 5,500 to 6,000 per month, and to restore the ecology. So these are the few things which are very unique while planning the BioVillage 2.0. So that is why this project has been named as BioVillage 2.0. So that people should understand, people should have the beneficiaries or the villagers should have that confidence. If my number one enterprise goes fail, then second is there.
When there are, jab koi bimar pad jata hai, for example, at home, the caregiving responsibilities also increases. So with climate change, the heat related illness, the malaria outbreaks, whatever water and vector borne diseases we are talking about, it increases the caregiving responsibilities, and in all kinds of conflicts and crisis situations, climate change is no different. Okay, next. So the women generally are facing the double burden of climate change, and when we are trying to kind of reduce, say, or give them more opportunities or provide them say access to whatever social services they are requiring, there are lots of bottlenecks. For example, the whole expectations from women, their limited access to knowledge and platforms, they're not part of resources.
So there's enormous physical vulnerability. It is exposed to slow and steady disasters such as sea level rise, associated land submergence, as well as drought, and rapid onset extreme level events such as cyclones, floods, heat waves. And additionally, West Bengal is also one of the highest, one of the most vulnerable states in terms of adaptive capacity, as the national vulnerability assessment states.
One of the departments which totally working on the renewable energy parts. That's called the Department. And all of you are aware that Adaptation is placed, so there's lots of pressure on environment and environment. So many departments like the Tourism Department, PDD Department, and the Renewable Energy Department, they're distributing, this solar water heater we have because in winter this water heater is very important. So they are distributing this solar water heater in homestays, hotels, and guest houses in covering the entire Kolkata. And the second very interesting this initiative taken by the irrigation department in Ladakh is the solar water irrigation pumps, especially because most of the villages in Ladakh, they are drought areas.
We are implementing solar rooftop projects. And in the Suraj scheme, we are implementing solar rooftop projects on all the Panchayati Raj institutions across southern India states. And in the Suraj scheme, we are focusing on implementing solar projects on the health institutions, so that health institutions' operational expenses can reduce.
So, DNA School Card project is a unique initiative done by the government to provide some sort of support to the schools, particularly the government schools in the state. So the kind of network that this DNA Club project has is immense. So we have a network of 122 government schools spread throughout the state, covering an approx of 12,500, if I'm not wrong. Yeah, 12,500 students from all across the state. And these students belong from the categories of, from the classes of class 8 to class 11 or max to 12.